Hello there, my glorious, chibilicious, chubby bunnies. I am here to give you another vlog. Today's vlog comes to you in three parts. Part one, an epic 80s montage. I highly enjoy my nerdy alter ego. Quantum physics, like a boss! Part two, some odd questions. Come on outside. So today I was asked a multitude of questions, including, why does your hand say sweet transvestite? Why are you wearing stripes? How come the only makeup you wear is black eyeliner and dark purple lipstick? Now, to answer said question, I have the word sweet transvestite written on my hand because I've recently been watching the Rocky Horror Picture Show continuously and simultaneously, and I must say it is absolutely freaking awesome. It is because of Rocky Horror Picture Show that I also have love and hate written on my left and right knuckles. Why do I wear stripes? I think that the better question would be, why don't you? Same goes for the heavy makeup. Why don't you wear it? There's nothing wrong with heavy makeup. It's just very dark, scary, and intimidating. And am I some kind of faggot? No, but the nail polish I'm wearing might imply differently. I'd best be quoting right now. The other day I found a journal entry from 1984. It simply said, people tell me I'm a star. Them. That sentiment was comforting to me at the time. It tells me that I was willing to stand up as an artist and not be strung up as a puppet. It looked to me like the beautiful people had stuck their noses under the circus tent and exclaimed, sorry we laughed at you. We didn't know you were going to be so popular and all the rage. Now we love you. Now we want to look like you. We'd love to introduce you to all our friends. Hence my journal entry. Them. How could I forgive them when I didn't even trust them? Not long before, they wouldn't let me into their little world, their restaurants, clubs, and hotels. I remember being asked, are you some kind of faggot? Just because I painted my nails. Part 3, an interesting story. It has recently occurred to me that I think the strangest of things, and while many people have noted that out to me before, it's only really come clear right now. Last night I got 3 hours of sleep. That's not very good for somebody that has to go to school bright and early the next day and do 3 tests. Our first test was 8 a.m. sharp, and it was a literacy test. We had to read and then answer questions based on the text. It was actually pretty easy compared to other literacy tests that I've done, but the lesson still took me about 40 minutes, which is pretty good, apparently. Another thing was that watching The Dark Knight and the Rocky Horror Picture Show the day before, when I was taking the test, I had the oddest background music inside my head. It was very strange because the answer for the questions were in an odd order. It was like A-A-A-A-A-B-B-C-D-A-A-B-C-D-A. Not very hard. So after answering A a couple of times in a row, I started to get quite curious as to if my answers were correct. And that's when the odd things started to happen. As I mentioned before, I had watched The Dark Knight and Rocky Horror Picture Show. So as I was answering, here's a pretty good recap of what was going on inside my head. A. But no, wait. No, that can't be A. The last one was A. No. No, but the first two were A too. Maybe this is B. No, B doesn't make sense. Takes its toll. What? What is this? How do I even have to do this? Is that Time Warp? Why is this Time Warp in my head? What? It's a pretty good song anyway. I guess. Transvestite aliens.
Wait, no, that's a Time Warp. Whoa, what's Time Warp? Is that Batman? What the heck is the Batman theme song?
It really brightened up the moment. I had Rocky Horror Picture Show playing in my head the rest of the day, so like I was doing a math test and then it was like, let's do the Time Warp again. Oh my goodness. It was lovely. And then around third block, I started getting Hot Patootie, Bless My Soul, stuck in my head, so I started writing it, like, everywhere, so the desk was, like, full of just Hot Patootie, Hot Patootie, Hot Patootie, Hot Patootie. It was pretty entertaining. I'm trying to imagine what the next kid would say. In short, I guess that if I don't want to be so stressed out for a test anymore, I just have to imagine songs from the Rocky Horror Picture Show playing in my head. I suppose that would make it much easier and, I guess, much more soothing, and it would also really support the day. Well, that's all I got for today, guys. Good night, good morning, good afternoon, whatever the heck it is, wherever you are, and goodbye. I will see you later. Why are you breathing so heavily?
I gotta live! You gotta breathe to live!